Hey YouTube, this is Mike from 3 Men in a Let's Play. I wanted to share a quick guide on how to get Scott Pilgrim working on RPCS3. So if you don't know, for the last couple years, you have not been able to buy or get in any legal way Scott Pilgrim, the game. Basically, the publishing deal with the maker just kind of expired. They didn't want to renew, and the game just kind of fell into a state of limbo. People that still own it can play it. Nobody new can buy it. So I'm super excited. Not too long ago, the blog for RPCS3, the PlayStation 3 emulator, announced in their May progress report, they have full 60 frames per second support for Scott Pilgrim. So I figured, hey, it's probably the perfect time to start playing it now. So I've never actually gotten to play it. I love the Scott Pilgrim movie. So we were excited on our channel to get into it. I wanted to share the guide, though, because it's not really straightforward to get this set up, and I figure other people would want to play it, too. So if you're watching, let me know if this has been helpful. Let me get right into it, and I'll go ahead and close. So to start with, I'm actually doing the installation on a virtual machine, and I will explain that a little more in a minute. Basically, let me get us right into the goods. So I'll have a bunch of links down at the bottom of the page in the description on the YouTubes. We'll start from the top. You'll want to get WinRAR or 7-Zip. If you don't already own it, you might have a little trouble in this guide. I'd assume most people who I'm basically explaining this video towards already have some form of WinRAR or WinZip. But to basically sum up what you need to do, you'll download the x64-bit version, and I'm assuming you have a 64-bit machine, because here's the RPCS3 main website, and under the Quick Start section is the minimum requirements, 64-bit Windows 7 or greater. It also will let you use Linux, but this guide is tailored towards the Windows release. Of course, you need an x64 processor, GPU that supports OpenGL 4.3 or greater. And to be honest, I'm not sure which models that would be. 4 gigs of RAM, recommended 8. So here's the problem that I found. On the official website, this link is actually broken. And this is a vital piece of software you need. Basically, the problem is this is some development library that the software needs in order to run. And at the time, it was the most current 2005 version. Now I believe we have 2017 is out there. Microsoft will basically put older versions of their development tools kind of on the back shelf. But anyway, before we get into that, let me go back to the download page. So what we'll do is on the RPCS3 page, click download. And as that loads, hopefully shouldn't take too long. There we go. You'll want to click here for the Windows release. And as of today, it's the 0.0024799 alpha. This is in a very early release stage, but Scott Pilgrim's a pretty simple game, so it doesn't take too much to run. So what do we do here? Well, I have a link in the description, the new way to download the 2015 C++ redistributable. So you'll go ahead, click download, make sure you have the x64 version, click next, and that'll begin the download. The next thing that you need to download is this DirectX runtime web installer. Now, most people actually don't need this because it's basically the DirectX tools that most games will come with. So if you're already a gamer, you likely don't need this. I actually didn't myself, but I'm going to go ahead and continue through the installation. First, make sure all these are unchecked unless you want any of these, which I doubt you would. These are just some of the free crap that usually gets bundled in downloads. The next thing, and I think it's pretty interesting, most emulators require you to download some version of the system software. Fortunately, this one, you can just download straight from Sony. So this is the actual PlayStation.com website. I guess you can point a PlayStation 3 browser here, or typically the PlayStation 3 browser does point here to update. I'm not sure how that works, but it's here. It's available for download. Most of the time, emulators have the problem where they don't want to include the low-level system functions because it's illegal. It's basically only original code in some cases. But this, in this case, it's pretty easy. So what do we do first? We have here is actually the Scott Pilgrim game. I can't tell you, unfortunately, where to get it. I have a few helpful tools that'll help you find it safely so that you don't get a lot of malware. Though I'm saving that towards the end of the video because that's sort of a long explanation. So anyway, the first thing we'll do here is go ahead and extract RPCS3. I always do extract files so that we get a nice download folder. So the first thing you'll notice, if you try to run it, you get this error. You're getting this error because we haven't installed the C++ redistributable. I'll go ahead and run it. You'll click I agree, install, you'll get a Windows user protection pop-up. It'll run through its thing. Done. Pretty straightforward. For the DirectX, I'll go ahead and show you. It's also pretty straightforward, but you don't necessarily need it. The one thing you do want to make sure is you do not install the Bing bar. So once it's done, you'll click Finish. Then we can go ahead and get into RPCS3. You'll go ahead and click I've read the quick start guide, do not show again, and click OK. Okay, so the first thing you'll want to do once you have RPCS3, you'll go to Install Firmware, and you'll want to navigate up to where you say PS3 updat.pup and click OK. It'll go through the install process. Once it's done, click OK. Then we want to install Scott Pilgrim. So you'll go to File, Install Package, Boot, Install Package. Click on your Scott Pilgrim. Click OK. There we go. You want to make sure it's the latest version of Scott Pilgrim is 1.03. Doesn't really matter which version you use, but this is the latest. So next you'll want to do a couple system settings. First we have your controllers under, by the way, system settings. Pad handler, depending on what you want to use. If you want to use a PlayStation 4 controller, you can plug it in with a wire and just do DualShock 4. If you want to use your Xbox controller like we do, you'll do X input. There's a lot of guides out there and people posting saying X input doesn't work. That's old. Recently they got X input working with this. Next, under graphics, you have to use OpenGL. Even if you have DirectX, it just crashes. Here you set your resolution. You'll want to do, I do, you know, the full monitor size that I have, 1920x1080. Next, under MISC, if you want full screen, start games in full screen. Next is the important part, because right now the game will run. If you want it to run full speed, you have to click Recompiler and hit OK. So now what happens when you go to boot, you'll get this dialog box. And what it's actually doing is it's going through the Scott Pilgrim code and translating it in basically a language that's easier for the emulator to understand. This way the game will run in 60 frames a second. This process does take around 2 to 5 minutes on my machine, although this is a virtual box, like I said. Now let me get into that. Basically, a virtual machine, or virtual box is the software, really. This is a computer running within my computer, and it's actually very useful if you want to stay secure and not ruin your main computer that you have running out around the outside. You can notice I have my toolbar down here for Windows 10, Windows 7 for my VirtualBox. Basically, on a virtual machine, you can do just about anything you want without worrying about, you know, screwing up your main machine. There's a few things that could happen. Basically, if you know this is an actual network computer, if you run into some malware that'll run on a network, it might be able to reach via your router, reach your host machine here. But, you know, that's mostly if you have certain network services like Windows file sharing enabled. But basically, if you want to find Scott Pilgrim, you can install a virtual machine or just go, you know, bareback. Google, you know, it's easy. Just Google Scott Pilgrim PlayStation 3 game. But we actually own the game on our old PS3. It's just out of commission. So, you know, be sure if there's a way you can, which at this point there isn't really a way to support the official release, otherwise I'd say it. But be sure to check out our YouTube channel that I'm subtly highlighting. 3 minute Let's Play, we're running this game next up on our show. If you like this video or need any help, leave a comment. And otherwise, have a good day.